Okay, so for today's video, we're going to take a quick look at negative fractional indices. We've actually recently done videos on negative indices and fractional indices. So if you want to check those videos out before carrying on with this one, then I'll leave links to them down in the description, and I'll also add a card in the top corner. So as I was saying, these questions here today on negative fractional indices are a combination of the negative indices and also fractional indices. So when we've looked at negative indices in the past, what we've actually been looking for is the reciprocal. So when we've got a term to a negative power, what we can do is simply write that as 1 over whatever the term is to the positive power. So for this first example, we have 36 to the power of negative a half. So once we see that negative indice, we know we've got a reciprocal, so we can write this as 1 over 36 to the power of positive a half. So now going back to fractional indices, the denominator shows what root we have to take, and then the numerator shows what power we then have to raise it to. Whenever we've got a 1 on top there, we don't need to do anything extra because raising to the power of 1 doesn't change anything. So for this example, we would have 1 over 36 to the power of a half would be, because we've got a 2 on the bottom, the square root of 36. So we've got 1 over the square root of 36, which we can then simplify to 1 over 6. Okay, this next question is slightly different as we have a number greater than 1 on the numerator. So we've got 125 to the power of negative 2/3. So again, the first thing we notice is that negative indice. So what we can do is write this as 1 over 125 to the power of positive 2 over 3. So now with our fractional indice, we have to do 1 over, we've got a 3 on the bottom, so we'll actually be doing the cube root of 125. And then once we get an answer to that, we then have to square it because we have our 2 on the numerator. So simplifying further, we've got 1 over, if we look inside the bracket, we've got the cube root of 125, which is just 5, but then we have to square it. So we've got 1 over 5 squared, which is 25. So the final answer to this one would be 1 over 25. Okay, so we've got some more questions to try. If you want to have a go at these first, feel free to pause the video here and we'll go through the answers in just a few seconds. Okay, so for this first example, we've got 144 to the power of negative a half. So because we have our negative power, we know we can write this as 1 over 144 to the power of positive a half. So just like the questions before, because we've got a 2 on the bottom, that means we're going to find the square root. So this one would just simply be 1 over, and the square root of 144 is 12. For this next one, we've got 625 to the power of negative a quarter. So again, we can replace that negative power with 1 over, and then we write 625 to the power of positive a quarter. So because we've got that 4 on the bottom this time, we're actually looking for the 4th root of 625. So for this final answer, we'd have 1 over, and then the 4th root of 625 is actually 5. So the final answer to this would be a 5th. Okay, so for this next question, we have 64 to the power of negative 2 over 3. So again, because we have that negative indice, we can write this as 1 over 64 to the power of positive 2 over 3. Which then we can simplify that down. We have 1 over, because we have a 3 on the bottom of that power, we're going to find the cube root of 64, which then we need to square. So now we've got 1 over, the cube root of 64 is 4, which then we need to square. So our final answer would be 1 over 16. And moving on to this next one, we've got 16 to the power of negative 3 over 4. So again, negative indice, we can write this as 1 over 16 to the power of positive 3 over 4. So this means this time we're going to have 1 over, because we've got a 4 on the bottom, we're going to find the 4th root of 16. And then once we find that, we have to cube it. So the 4th root of 16 is actually 2, which then we have to cube. So this would simplify to 1 over 2 cubed is 8, so our final answer would be 1 over 8. So well done if you followed along and got them right. Let's have a look at some more questions. Okay, so for these questions, we're looking for the negative fractional indice of some fractions. So again, going back to our negative indices when we've got fractions, we're still looking for the reciprocal. So when we're looking for the reciprocal of a fraction, all we have to do is flip it upside down. So for this first one, for example, I've got 36 over 49 to the power of negative a half. So because we've got that negative power, we're looking for a reciprocal. So that's the same as saying 49 over 36 to the power of positive a half. So because we've got this power of positive a half, we're therefore, we look at the bottom number, it's a 2, so we're looking for the square root of both bits. So this is the same as the square root of 49 over the square root of 36. Then all we have to do is simplify these. So the square root of 49 is 7, and the square root of 36 is 6. So our final answer to that would be 7 over 6. Okay, for this next question, we've got 27 over 64 to the power of negative 2 over 3. So again, that negative power means we're looking for the reciprocal. Because I've got a fraction, all I have to do is flip it. So this 27 over 64 to the negative 2 over 3 is exactly the same as saying 64 over 27 to the power of positive 2 over 3. So now applying our fractional indices, we have to find the cube root because that's on the denominator. And then once we find the cube root of the fraction, we have to then square it, shown by the numerator. So we can simply write this as the cube root of 64 over the cube root of 27, which then we're going to square. So if we do this bit in the fraction first, we've got the cube root of 64, which is 4, over the cube root of 27, which is 3. So we get 4 over 3, but then remember, we have to square it. So then squaring the fraction, we've got to do 4 squared, which is 16. And then on the bottom, we'd have 3 squared, which is 9. So our final answer to that one would be 16 over 9. Okay, there's a final two more questions here to have a go at if you want, so feel free to pause the video again, and we'll go through these in just a few seconds. Okay, for the first question, we've got 125 over 8 to the power of negative a third. So again, negative indice, we know we're looking for the reciprocal. Because I've got a fraction, I'm going to flip it. So this is the same as writing 8 over 125 to the power of positive a third. So again, because we've got a 3 on the bottom, we know we're looking for the cube root. So this is the same as the cube root of 8 over the cube root of 125. So simplifying, we have the cube root of 8, which is 2, over the cube root of 125, which is 5. So that one would be 2 over 5. And finally, we have 625 over 81 to the power of negative 3 quarters. So again, negative indice, we're looking for the reciprocal. We're going to flip this so it becomes 81 over 625 to the power of positive 3 over 4. So again, the denominator shows the root, and then the numerator shows the power, which we're then going to raise it to. So what we'd have to do with this one, we'd have to find the fourth root of the fraction. So the fourth root of 81 over the fourth root of 625. And then whatever we get for that, we then have to cube. So the fourth root of 81 is actually 3. And the fourth root of 625 is 5. Then I've got 3/5, but then I've got to raise that to the power of 3, or cube it. So then to finish this one off, we've got 3 cubed, which is 27. And on the bottom, we'd have 5 cubed, which is 125. So the final answer to this one would be 27 over 125. And that's the last question for today's video. Well, I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any specific topics at all that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to go through those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.